How you doing? Welcome to another tutorial video. Today I want to talk to you about expectations, soreness, and rest periods. These are things that particularly beginners have to understand and have to know how to deal with these things, otherwise it can lead to overtraining or false expectations. Let's start with expectations. Everybody comes into a program with expectations of wanting to achieve something, which is great. Lose weight, put on muscle, learn a kick, learn kettlebell movements, animal flow, whatever it is. Your expectations have to be realistic. In other words, how long they're going to take. Do not expect things to happen really quickly overnight. These things take time. And according to your discipline and your dedication and how hard you practice and get things right and be patient, and then your expectations will happen. But you need to come in realistically and understand that programs take time. If you question the program, often people leave. That can lead to people giving up because their expectations are not real of how quick they think it should happen. They might have 2 weeks in their head when I think it could be 4 months. So we need to be real with our expectations and be very patient, and then things will happen for you. But don't come in with an unrealistic expectation. Otherwise, again, this can lead to negativity and people getting frustrated and then giving up. So let's keep it real in our expectations, and I promise you, you will achieve what you want to achieve. Next thing is soreness. What I mean is how sore your body gets after training. Generally, that can be according to obviously how hard you train and experience level. Obviously, when you come into a training program at the start, your soreness level will be a lot higher. People can call it DOMS, delayed onset muscle soreness. Usually the second day after training is the worst. So often people will come in saying, "Coach, I want to go harder. I don't feel like I'm working hard enough." But I know you are new to training, you need to take it easy. And I will say, trust me. Sure enough, 2 days later, they're telling me they're very sore and thank you for not pushing too hard. That soreness will fade as you train more. This is the reason we keep mixing up our training. We want our body to be forced to adapt to different methods. Whether you change the rounds, the reps, the rest periods, the tempo, whatever it is, we adjust these things to keep making the body adapt to different program methods so it keeps growing or shrinking or whatever your goals may be in your training. So understand that the soreness level will be according to that, your experience, all of these things. But we don't want to come in and get too sore. We're about to keep our body moving. Sure, a bit of touch soreness where we go, "Oh, I can feel my work," but not to the point where we can't train anymore. We've got to be very careful we get that line right so we don't stop our training and we keep progressing and adapting and growing and achieving what we want to achieve. This is really important. Next thing is rest periods. This is a problem with some people, particularly beginners. They come in very gung-ho, and they want to work hard, and they're not understanding that those rest periods are very, very important. Obviously, to rest your body, so you feel better and you're not as tired. But what happens when you rest is your body grows, and all these things you want to achieve, whether you want to lose weight, put on muscle, get flexible, learn skills, they all get imprinted into your bodies. Even the skills you learn, you have time to think about them, remind yourself in the brain until next time. Regarding growing muscle, your muscle grows when you're resting. So we can't keep working every day the same muscle. It can be hard. Your body needs time to, you're breaking it down essentially, and then it needs to repair and grow. You're breaking it down, it repairs and grows. So understand, rest periods are important. I've seen people see their program and go, "I don't need the rest off, I want to train today." Trust me, you need to do it, you need to take the rest. Sometimes you feel like you want to do it and you've got a lot of energy, that's great. Take that energy into the next day. Don't use it all. Don't get to the point where you're getting too fatigued and you can't move at all. I need you to trust the rest periods. Sure, I will write in 3 days in most of these programs when it comes to your hypertrophy, and there's a fourth day, but that allows you to play around. You can do your three and not do the fourth as a top up, and then you have other days off. So it's 3 to 4 days out of the week training, and then you have either, depending how many days you've done, 3 to 4 more days where you can rest, play football, play tennis, swim, bike ride, whatever it is. So we don't overtrain, and in between our hard training, we have our what we call active recovery days, and I want to keep that active recovery correct. I see people's active recovery days being 10 kilometer runs. That is not an active recovery, that is exercise. So we need to understand that active rest or active recovery is going for a walk, having a gentle swim, going for a light bike ride, keeping it as recovery and remembering that word. So I hope these tips help you out, guys. Remember, these are important things to learn and remember as your program goes, as you develop as an athlete, because you are an athlete and you will learn more from this and get a lot better rewards. And be patient, understand the program, trust the program, and you will get there. Cheers.